stand up. Stand up for Jesus, Jesus, stand up. Stand up. The promises of Christ, my Savior. Standing on the promises of God. I'm standing on the promises of Christ, my Savior. On the promises of God. Stand up. Stand up for Jesus. Stand up. Hello, God bless you, my brother and my sister out there all through the world. I love you, and I want you to know that Jesus loves you the more. God bless you. Welcome to today's word. Standing on the promises of God is what we are talking about. And today is the second part, Standing on the Promises of God, part 2. We learned yesterday from 2 Peter chapter 1, verse number 4, that the promises of God are exceedingly great. That is, they are so numerous, our human hearts, human man cannot comprehend them all. And the Bible also says they are precious. They are so precious. They are invaluable. They comfort the soul. They make joyful the heart. So the promises of God are indescribably great and indescribably precious. And on this second day, I want us to see why do we consider the promises of God so reliable that we must stand on them? Why are the promises of God so reliable that we must stand on them? Number one is that it is impossible for God to lie. Hebrews chapter 6 verse 18 says it is impossible for God to lie. So when God makes a promise to you, he will not be lying. He will be so true, because otherwise he would not have been himself. God can never lie. It is impossible for God to lie. And in Romans chapter 3 verse 4, the Bible says, let God be true and all men liars. So if every human being even should lie, God will still remain true. God can never lie. That is the first reason why we can stand on his promises. Number two is that the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 20 that his promises are yes and amen. What does that mean? His promises, you know, there's this popular song we sing, when Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. So the promises of God are yes. Nobody can say no to the promises of God. Nobody can upturn the promises of God. When God says yes concerning anything he wants to do for you, nobody can undo that yes. The only thing we can say to the promises of God will be amen, which means so be it, because it cannot be removed. Number three reason why we can stand on the promises of God is what the Bible describes as the immutability of his counsel, immutability of his counsel or promise. You know, the Bible says the promises or counsels of God are immutable. That means they are unchangeable, unshakable, unalterable, uneradicable, indelible. It's irreversible. It is constant. It is stable. The promises of God are ineradicable. No one can eradicate it. The promises of God are immutable. And so you can take it to the bank. The promises of God are unchangeable. Number four reason why we can stand on the promises of God is what is written in Hebrews chapter 6. Verse 13 and verse 14, the Bible says the promises of God are sealed with an oath. The Bible says God made a promise to Abraham, and not being able to swear by any other thing, he swore by himself to assure Abraham that those promises, or that particular promise, will come to pass. So the promises of God, they are sealed with an oath, the oath of God. And oh, you remember, The Bible says in Psalm 130 verse 2, it said God has lifted his word above his name. That means God is bound by whatever he says. God is bound by his own word. He cannot disobey his own word. So the promises of God are immutable, and they are sealed with an oath, and they are yes and amen, and it is impossible for God to lie. For this reason, I want to encourage you, stand on the promises of God. Whatever may be happening in the world today, it cannot upturn the promises of God towards you. And let me leave you with this. In Hebrews chapter 10 verse 23, the Bible says, let us hold fast to the profession of our faith or our hope without wavering, because he who has promised, he is faithful. God is too faithful to fail. Therefore, stand on his promises. Whatever he has promised you in any area, concerning any area of your life, I can vouch for God, for my God, that he will make it to come to pass. There shall be a performance of everything God has promised you. You will not be a loser, and you will be a winner. In Jesus' name, God bless you. I love you. But Jesus loves you more. Amen.